Hey guys, Wild for Games here for you, and today I'm going to show you how to use Twitch stats to help possibly grow your channel and use it for your own analytics to help evolve and perhaps even grow. Let's get started. All right, first things first, you got to get to the Twitch dashboard. If you're not sure how to do that, go to the bottom left-hand corner, tick on the arrow, and go to the panel that says dashboard. It should be right there in the middle. It'll take you to the default modular panels that Twitch has. The one you guys are all concerned with that you've noticed mostly is the stats panel. That'll show you who's following you, how many views, and how many follows, and how long you've been streaming for. This one's pretty self-explanatory, so we're going to skip that, and we're going to go straight up to the stats tab at the very top. Let that load. Now we're actually in Twitch stats. It should take you to the default video plays by group and by hour. It'll give you the most current month you're in, and you can change this to whatever month of any past month you want to look at. What I like to do is I always like to change hourly to daily. I only stream for about 3 to 5 hours at a time, so it doesn't really behoove me to check every hour. If you're probably a full-time streamer or a partner streamer, you probably want to select hour to see what has the greatest impact and when. The first box we're going to concern ourselves with is kind of the main filter. If we click on it, you'll see there's a bunch of different filter options we can choose. Number one is number of commercial breaks, chat activity, commercial breaks by second, concurrent viewers, followers, max concurrent viewers, time broadcast, time watched, and if we continue scrolling down, you'll see there's unfollows, unique visitors, and video plays. For this video, at the moment, we're going to concern ourselves with video plays and come back to the other ones. If you're not sure what anything is that you load for a filter, this info button over here will load for you to let you know what you've actually selected. So for video plays selected by no group, by daily resolution, it shows me the number of times a video is loaded over the course of a selected time period. If we go to the middle box here, we're going to get some sub-filters. And this is where it gets fun and interesting, because you're going to get about 5 to 6 different options here. You've got none, URL, player type, geo, live/archive, and host. From here, you get to choose a bunch of different ones. Let's start with URL, since we already none means nothing. URL is actually what are people watching you from. Now, there's only so many places you can watch Twitch from, but a lot of them will be embedded in different websites. This gives you kind of just a generic look. As you can see, it lists out the top three here for me. No surprise, the biggest one is twitch.tv, then it's undefined, and then it's player.twitch.tv. I have no idea what this last one is. Maybe it's a new mobile app. I'm not sure. The next filter we're going to look at is going to be player type. Select that, let it load, and this will show you all the different players and devices that actually show your stream live that people are watching from. No surprise that the biggest one obviously is site, which is most likely twitch.tv, but I was surprised to know that how many people actually watch me from Android and mobile and iPhone devices. This may actually be useful information depending on when you stream and what you stream, as you may want to reconsider how many kilobytes you actually broadcast at. This may be really beneficial for new streamers. Let's take a look at the next category. The next one is geo, and this is actually going to show the region / country of where you're most viewed from. I live in the United States, so it's not a surprise that most of my viewers watch me from the United States itself. But it gives a lot of insight of where other people are watching you from. Again, this will list the top 10, and for me, just right off the bat, I have Canada, followed by United Kingdom, Mexico, Germany, and Russian Federation. What can you do with this information? Well, it depends on how you want to kind of actually attune your stream for your viewers. You might actually have more insightful things to say about those places. I mean, granted, the United States is my main subject matter, but maybe I can have more engaged conversations with Canadians by knowing more Canadian facts or asking things about history questions or insightful things about the United Kingdom and so forth and so forth. From there, we can go to live and archive. This will show you how many people watch your live stream versus your archive streams and so forth. Unfortunately, I do not know what one stands for and undefined. Maybe we'll find out, or if anybody knows, feel free to let me know in the comments. But here's how many people watch you live versus your archive streams. Next, we're going to look at one of my favorite ones, which is host. This actually shows you who hosts you, on what day, and for how many viewers. Now, there is a little bit of a hiccup of it because it's not always perfect, nor does it always give me the right number. It gives me more of a generalization. And I haven't figured out what series one is. I assume since Twitch started the auto-hosting feature, all of the auto-hosts get lumped into series one. I do get about 40 to 60 auto-hosts per stream. I'm assuming it's that, but I'm not sure. But it again, we'll show you the top 10 of who hosts you the much over the course of time for that given month. And you can actually go up to the given day and see who has hosted you. Minusing out these series ones that I have Pro Rocket League streaming me, and then Tyler Dwarf, X-Water, and so forth. It's very useful information because you might want to tweet these people out and thank them for the actual host, helping you grow in turn and also recognizing them as doing you a favor. Now let's take a quick look at all the other main filters there are. Some of these are self-explanatory, so we'll go through these quick. Go to the main first box, and up at the top, we're going to have number of commercial breaks. Now, I'm not a partnered streamer at this moment, so I won't have any information here, and most likely a lot of you won't either. So unfortunately, I can't give you much information on this. Maybe a partner can comment, or you might be able to ask them certain questions about it. The next one is chat activity. This will let you know how active your chat is by how many messages are actually sent through your chat window. I actually like to look at this because it lets me know how active my community is and how engaging I am to them. The more I talk, the more I have open-ended questions, the more comments and more feedback and messages they have. I always try to keep mine at a certain number because I want them to be engaged. The next one we have is commercial breaks per second. Again, I'm not a partnered streamer, so I'm just going to go ahead and skip over this, but it seems pretty self-explanatory. The next we have is concurrent viewers. This is how many viewers watch you per stream on average over the given day. So as we go across here, this will let you know what you're growing at. I'm a pretty small streamer, so I only get about 25 to 30 people per stream, depending on what I'm streaming. So it's kind of nice to see what game I'm playing or creative thing I'm painting and how effective it is for the community and new viewers that pop in. Going across, you can see some of these I have 25, but I even hit 50 to even 40. On this given day, I was hosted by a pretty big streamer because I was playing Rocket League and their whole community joined in. So we'll take that as a one-off. But it is nice to see on what game and what day you do, on what has an effect on certain communities and people. The next we have here is how many follows you get per stream, per day. I usually don't get that much anymore, but it's nice to see what days, again, and what game or what creative thing I play that pulls in the most people. If you scroll across, you'll just actually see how many you get. Side note out there, this isn't always accurate. I have noticed if I maybe get no viewers on Friday, or follows I should say on Friday, that's because it either pushes them to the day prior or pushes it to the day after and combines all these numbers into one. You'll actually have better luck on a third party program, perhaps like Streamlabs, StreamHatch, or even Social Blade. But this gives you a nice generic number. The next is max concurrent viewers. This gives you the max average concurrent per stream that you hit for a certain amount of time. As you can see, as you scroll across, what I pull in per day on average here. Some days I do really well, some days not as much. It's nice to see, again, what game I'm streaming or creative thing I'm doing that pulls in the most people. And it's very insightful because if I have a really high number one day and didn't get that many follows, it lets me reflect on what maybe I didn't do to grab them for that follow and recalibrate what I want to say when I'm in stream. So it's a good way to reevaluate your streams and yourself. And the next we have here is time broadcast. Pretty self-explanatory. This is in hours, how many hours I do per stream. Like I said, I normally do somewhere between 3 and 5 hours. My average number is around 4 for when I paint and around 5 for when I play games. The next one we have is time watch. This is how many times somebody actually loads the player to watch your stream and how many collective hours there is. So you can see how many hours we have total going across by taking our slider and going as well. Next we have unfollows. This is pretty easy. How many times somebody unfollows you per stream? I'm actually surprised I don't have more unfollows. But it looks like on one day I hit about 20. Maybe this is when people came in for a giveaway, join in the giveaway and just leave. Or maybe I did something that didn't resonate with certain people or a community or it could be a variety of things. But this also lets you know insightfully how to change and reevaluate your stream as well. Next thing we have down here is unique viewers. I believe this is how many times an IP address is loaded for your stream for that given day, and it counts it as one unique view. So for just example, I had 240 IPs or people click on my stream. This is very insightful, again, for the sheer fact of what can I be doing to actually grab these people to make them one, viewers, two, followers, and three, regulars, and four, always returning to my stream during those given hours. Next, we're gonna have video plays, which is the last one that we ended on. If any of you ever wanna make adjustments to any way you look at your data, you can always use day, week, or month to look at a specific spot. For instance, if I wanna look at a certain week that might not be a calendar Sunday to Saturday, I can always move my slider accordingly to pull in that exact data. Maybe I wanna look from Wednesday to Wednesday, or perhaps even Thursday to Friday. You can make any change that you want by grabbing these sliders and making the necessary change. If you wanna export your data, go up to the top right-hand corner here and you'll have export and you'll have print. This is a great way to actually see what kind of data you're pulling in. I used to all the time export my data, throw it into Excel, and then see how many average numbers I give for a certain week or for a certain game. Now again, there are third-party programs that will help you out with this, and I probably will cover those in another stream or another video at another time. I hope this video was helpful for you guys, and I hope these simple stats will help you make adjustments that'll help grow your stream or at least engage more with your audience or give you some insight to how Twitch stats actually work. I know this isn't comprehensive and there are some better ways of doing this, but I just want to give you some of the generalizations that this can actually help you and your community and your channel. Hopefully that was really helpful for you guys. I know there's a lot of third-party websites out there that can show you a lot of different analytics, and they actually do it better. If you guys like this video, I'll be more than happy to go over those websites. I use them all the time myself. However, Twitch Stats does show you some fine things that you can't find on other third-party programs. Hopefully this will help evolve, perhaps change, or even help you grow your channel. If you guys like this video, make sure to give it a nice thumbs up. If you do like these type of videos, please let me know in the comments below. You can always follow me on Twitch, Twitter, this YouTube channel, Instagram, and Snapchat. If you guys did like this video, there's some other ones over there on the side that you can check out. Thank you so much, and I'll see you on Twitch. Have a good one. Peace.